Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Zachary Blissful once again with you. And my friend, allow me to represent you a unique interview. Well, it's a regular interview with a unique person, Елена Рохлина, Helen Рохлина. She is a daughter of a Russian general, Lev Rokhlin. Lev Rokhlin was a commander-in-chief of Russian army during the period of the First Chechen War, which was called later words something like anti-terroristic operation. How can the entire nation be claimed as terrorists? I can't imagine. So couldn't do that General Lev Rokhlin. God protect him throughout eternity. I really do respect this gentleman, for he was the great Russian general. He protected his young 18 years old soldiers who didn't get even boot camp training and came to the acting army immediately, and he protected them. And meanwhile, he protected peaceful Chechen population, because he realized, he knew, and he spoke about that they are same citizens of Russia as other nations. It was a terrible war, and General Rokhlin acted as a hero. Later, it's all is a rumors, but one of the rumors is that he addressed to Yeltsin, Boris Yeltsin, the crime president, terrible bloody dictator. He addressed to him, stop the war, stop inflaming the war, or I will act. General Rokhlin was found killed in his own bed, in his house, in close to Moscow, in the country of Moscow. He was found killed by a special automatic handgun, Stechkin. And blamed in this murder was his wife, widow, Tamara Rokhlina. And she couldn't physically grab this handgun and shot physically. It's a heavy 25 rounds loaded heavy army special forces gun, and he was shot. Also, there were found three burned bodies, three burned corpses not far from his home, and everybody who has sanity realizes that it was special operation of secret services, the ones who have to protect us against terrorists. Widow was blamed in the murder. She had a hard life, but she is a hero, the same as her husband. May God rest him in peace. So, people, forwards you will see interview with a brave lady, daughter of General Lev Rokhlin. I do respect her, and hope the same thing from you. I expect the same thing from you, at least in commentaries. For me, she's a little tiny piece of real opposition of Russia. Because I have seen the opposition, and 95% of them are trickers paid up by the government of Russian Federation and bloody Putin's regime. Елена Рохлина is not one of them. She is a decent person, one of few, the few, the brave, the Russians. Good evening, our dear friends. This is Елена Рохлина standing by me, And she allowed me to ask her several questions. It is convenient for her to speak in Russian, and I will interpret it for you into English simultaneously, hopefully, my dear friends. Елена, добрый вечер.
Добрый вечер.
Сегодня вы представляете собой одну из значительных частей российской оппозиции. Today you represent one of the most significant parts of Russian opposition. Почему я так говорю? Потому что вам люди действительно верят. Я лично вам верю. Why I'm saying this is because people do believe you, do trust you, and I do trust you and respect you. И уважаю вас. Скажите, пожалуйста, Елена, вот как вы считаете, каковы перспективы у российской оппозиции в ее сегодняшнем виде? Ну, как-то изменить ситуацию?
Думаю, что вот сейчас перспективы достаточно большие. Вот то, что задумал Путин с его плебисцитом, оно многих возмутит. Как ни странно, больше возмутит, чем пенсионная реформа.
I believe that Russian opposition has pretty good chances today for changes. It might sound strange, but today's modification of existing constitution might call up people more than it happened with pension reform, actually, which is a pension robbery. When President Putin raised up the pension age up to 65 from 60 years old. Это я пересказал суть пенсионной реформы. Второй вопрос. Елена, как вы считаете, вот режим Путина, он просто антироссийский, антирусский или он вообще античеловеческий? Ну, потому что если судить по свалкам и прочим делам, то уже не просто российское, а глобальное какое-то зло. Сейчас я переведу. Dear Елена, do you believe that Putin's regime is only anti-Russian or it is anti-human in planetary scale because of the garbage, nuclear disposal and other pleasant stuff.
Я этот режим называю геноцидники. Они занимаются геноцидом уже, наверное, 30 лет в России. И, конечно, паразитизм, он не может, вот, когда он еще так долго существует, он не может быть только локальным. Он распространяется вот на всю планету, понимаете? Не бывает так, что паразиты существуют и питаются долго-долго, и не приносят вред окружающей среде за пределами своего вот этого еще питания.
It can be that parasites evil bodies are just in one region without spreading themselves anywhere else. It appears to be that Putin's regime, which I do call genociders, they basically they multiply everywhere around the planet. And listen to me, people, they do. They might become your neighbors soon. Это я добавил, что люди действительно это так, и вскоре эти паразиты могут быть вашими соседями. И напоследок
да,
маленький...
Они там уже это свои гнезда расположили в этих странах благополучных.
They not might be, but they already nested in your countries, in your lands, people, in your free lands. И напоследок вопрос, как сегодня ваша семья, как мама себя чувствует, как ваши дела? And the last question, how is your family, how is your mama feeling today, how are you doing, people?
Мама в больнице, ну, состояние более-менее, но тем не менее находится в реанимации. Ну, потому что уже вот тяжелая достаточно жизнь у нее, здоровья совершенно нет. И... Надеюсь, окажут помощь медицинскую. С Божьей помощью справимся как-нибудь.
Mother is in active care currently in the hospital. She is ill. She had very hard life. And now we just hope, and me either, and my friend filming this video, we all hope that mother will get better with God's help. Godspeed. Спасибо вам огромное, спасибо. Елена. Что ж, остается только пожелать вам доброго вечера. Может, скажете что-нибудь зрителям на английском? Что-нибудь вроде хорошего вечера.
20 лет я не говорила
по-английски. Have a good evening.
Нет.
Ну ладно, good
Thank
evening.
Thank you very much, я скажу. Скажите. Ну, это очень как-то достаточно примитивно.
Ну, thank you very much from us both.
Спасибо.
Спасибо. Friends, widow of General Rocklin needs support. She is in the hospital now. I address it to English-speaking audience. It's not huge yet, but I hope it will be if you people will support our little channel and our huge effort. Елена Рохлина needs help for her family. If you will decide to do so, in the description of this video you will find information of how to support her or how to support me. If you'll decide to support family of Rochlins, the brave, heroic, peaceful family of Rochlins, look in the description. With all due respect, Zach the Blissful.